Hello and welcome to the Digital Intergeo 2020. Today we're going to listen to Tofik and Maximilian present about the high accuracy positioning anywhere with VRS and Trimble RTX GNSS corrections. You have the possibility to ask us questions by putting those questions in the chat box, and we'll have a question and answer phase around after the presentation for about 10 minutes. So with that, I'll hand over to Tofik.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Tofik, and I am the product manager for Trimble RTX. I'm joined with my colleague, Max, who is also a product manager for Trimble RTX. Today, we're going to be speaking about geospatial GNSS receivers along with VRS and Trimble RTX corrections. The key takeaways that we have from today's session include understanding the key benefits of correction services and how it's used to achieve high accuracy positioning for your surveying and mapping projects. We'll speak about both Trimble VRS Now and Trimble RTX and the benefits, use cases, and how they integrate into the Trimble solution. I'll start off by giving an introduction to corrections. To explain high accuracy positioning and corrections, I'll start with basic GPS positioning. This will be a quick overview. So you take your receiver out, you turn it on, and you get signals from the orbiting GNSS or GPS satellites. Nothing else. This gives you about 3 to 5 meters of horizontal and vertical accuracy. We don't consider this high accuracy. We refer to it as autonomous positioning. It's not good enough for most practical work being done in a professional capacity. In order to get high accuracy, you'll need some sort of corrections. Corrections allow for accuracy, but also repeatability, which in turn can help you reduce time, labor, and material costs, and also increase the accuracy of your estimates. The second correction method I want to speak about is SBAS. This can be WASS in North America or EGNOS in Europe, and there are other regionally available SBAS corrections as well. I wouldn't consider this true high accuracy either. It is GPS only in most cases. You can see a couple of these satellites are cut off. Essentially, this means that of all the GNSS satellites available in the sky or that your receiver is capable of using, you're only using a subset of those for positioning. There's limited applications where this is practical. The accuracy is fairly low. It's not necessarily repeatable. The availability is continental, and typically this is a free service that's available, but there is no support. The next method of corrections I want to speak about is RTK. This is something that most people are probably familiar with. It is one of the most common methods to be used for high accuracy corrections. How this works is you have a secondary GNSS receiver set up, known as your RTK base station. You have to set this up accurately over a known control point, have radio communication with your GNSS receiver, and you receive corrections through there. As long as you are within range of your RTK base station to receive that communication, you'll receive corrections. And the corrections, accuracy of the corrections typically diverges as you get further away from the base station. So the closer you are to the base station, the higher accuracy you'll have. It does require radio connectivity. You typically do need to stay close, fairly close to the base station in order to achieve higher accuracy. It's very accurate, repeatable, and there is some expertise and time required in order to set up that base station properly. The next method is VRS positioning. This doesn't use a single RTK base station, but actually uses a network of base stations. These are all connected via internet to a central server, which is creating the corrections and delivering them via internet. You'll typically have a modem or some sort of cellular internet connection on your receiver. This is suitable to be used where you do have cellular network coverage and you're within a VRS network coverage area. Very highly accurate and repeatable, similar to RTK, and dependent on the VRS network, as long as you're within the network, you should be able to achieve these accuracies. This is typically a subscription-based service provided by the network owner. A unique benefit of Trimble receivers, such as the R12, is exfil. Now, if you're using either RTK or VRS, and somehow your connectivity from radio or your modem gets cut off, you can continuously position at centimeter level positioning for a few minutes using exfil. This is broadcast by a geostationary satellite. It's always continuously being tracked and the corrections are received. And as soon as you lose your radio or modem connection, you have your exfil position. Now, if you don't have an RTK correction or a VRS correction, you don't have radio or internet connectivity at all, you do have a third option. This is Trimble RTX. Now, you don't have to initially connect to RTK or VRS. There's no radio required, there's no modem required. You get the corrections via satellite, which is actually on the same frequency band as GPS. You're able to get 2 centimeters horizontal and 5 centimeter vertical accuracy. This is available almost anywhere where the RTX satellite is visible. I'll show you the coverage area of satellite availability in a few slides. Now, one of the key benefits of RTX is satellite delivery, but I should also mention that it is also available via internet. It will be the same correction, either received via a internet source or through the satellite source. This is available almost anywhere in the world, highly accurate, repeatable. This is also a subscription-based service. I went over 3 main types of corrections available for high accuracy positioning. We understand that each type of project or job has unique requirement and varied requirements, and the corrections you choose may vary as well. You have the choice of corrections based on availability and accuracy, as well as budget. Trimble RTX and the integration with survey and mapping and GIS solutions does offer some unique benefits, and I will review those next. With challenges of project budgets, you want to minimize time, money, and expertise required, and have corrections that are available homogeneously. You may need to serve various project sizes. You may have unique site conditions and logistics working through multiple regions or along large corridor areas. Typical solutions of RTK make this increase the cost associated with trying to serve these projects or make it more difficult or impractical to achieve. Using a subscription-based service, either delivered via satellite or internet, can help mitigate and save costs. A unique benefit of VRS now is that it is available across a region, but a greater benefit of Trimble RTX is that it can be available across an entire continent. Another challenge that's faced on some job sites include no radio line of sight or radio interference. This can be due to some sort of communication interference, or it may be due to obstructions that are limiting your capability of achieving that communication link, such as there could be trains or obstructions between yourself and the base. There can be interference caused by any sort of other sensors that are working in that same area. There can be cellular congestion on the cellular network, limiting your access to internet availability. In this case, VRS may be used in some cases, but L-band satellite delivered corrections will also be available and may be used in more cases. Another challenge that people may face is the lack of cellular coverage or a lack of VRS network availability. As I mentioned before, VRS is regionally available and requires a cellular connection or an internet connection. Therefore, if you're in a remote area or a job site and you don't have VRS available, a network hasn't been established, or your cellular connection is poor or non-existent. The solution can be satellite delivered RTX corrections. A quick review of Trimble VRS Now specifications. As I mentioned earlier, these are the high accuracy specifications. This is a general spec that you'll achieve anywhere inside the network. It is available via cellular or internet, and the availability is regional. On the next slide here, I'll show you the actual coverage area that we have. We have North America, New Zealand, and Australia on the left, and of course, coverage in Europe on the right. In contrast, I'll switch over to our Trimble RTX portfolio. So we have different flavors of RTX. These are different services that offer different accuracy values. You can pick and choose the service that meets your needs. You don't need to pay for the top accuracy if that's overkill for the application that you're interested in. Our specification for CenterPoint RTX has improved. It is at 2 centimeters horizontal and 5 centimeters vertical. And convergence time has also improved to less than 1 minute in fast regions and less than 15 minutes. Convergence refers to the time that it takes for the solution to initialize to the specified accuracies. This is a one-time initialization at the beginning of the day, and then you're good until you lose convergence. The spec improvement also included, did also include the improvement convergence, and we've significantly increased the coverage area that we have fast convergence available. As mentioned before, the delivery is primarily used via satellite, but it is also available via cellular IP, and it is essentially available anywhere on the globe. This is a map of the satellite coverage area. Each different color represents a different satellite beam that's being used. Otherwise, internet availability is available anywhere on the globe where you are able to receive an internet connection. As mentioned, we have increased the area of fast coverage. So just recently, we've increased the coverage in North America with coast-to-coast coverage in the United States. And in Western Europe, we have a very good amount of countries covered as well. Again, this is where you have less than 1 minute convergence. In most cases, it's not noticeable, and you're able to start working right away. Another improvement that was made this year is an improvement in the coordinate system workflows. If you are familiar with PPP solutions or Trimble RTX, the positions are always computed on the receiver in a global reference frame, the ITRF 2014 current epoch. Beginning with Trimble Access 2020, that we are continuing to measure at the current epoch. However, the software is now transforming to a global reference datum using a time-dependent transformation. What this ultimately means is that your RTX positions are now going to be much closer to your local control. Similar workflow improvements have also been made in mapping and GIS software. Here's a quick overview, a brief list of or images of compatible RTX hardware from Trimble. On the left side, we have the EM100 and Trimble R1. These are sub-meter devices that are used for mapping and GIS applications. In the middle, we have the TDC 150 and the GEO 7 X. These are more on the decimeter level, again, used for mapping GIS applications. And on the bottom right, we have some survey receivers, the Spectra Precision SP60, the Trimble R2, and the Trimble R10, which and also the Trimble R12 or the R12i, which also support CenterPoint RTX. In the top right, I have the Trimble Catalyst / DA1 antenna. This does use Trimble RTX technology, so I thought I would include it here. For a full list of compatible devices, you can visit our website. For compatible software, we have software serving the survey applications, mapping applications. We also support third-party software, including Esri, as well as their new field software, Field Maps. For other software, we have the Trimble Mobile Manager application, which essentially allows you to use Trimble receivers with RTX positioning for any application on your Android or iOS device. The Trimble Precision SDK is an API that third-party software vendors can use to directly integrate Trimble receivers and Trimble positioning within their software. There are a number of partner Trimble partners that are utilizing the TP SDK and can thus utilize Trimble receivers along with RTX positioning. That's all I have for our presentation. Please fill out any questions that you have within the questions box. And for the next steps, I would encourage you to reach out to your local Trimble dealer. I have a link here, and you can find out how you can get a demonstration of any of these Trimble receivers, software, and Trimble RTX. If you already have a receiver, take a look at 30daytrial.trimble.com, promo code FREE30, and you'll be able to get a free 30-day trial to try any of our Trimble RTX services with your receiver. Thank you. All right, Max, do we have any questions?
Yeah, question, can I receive a copy of the presentation?
Yes, absolutely. A recording, and Sophie, do you know if a copy of the presentation is shared or is it just the recording?
Yes, we'll have there'll be a recording link that will be sent out to everybody who's registered in a follow-up email. So it's the recording, not the copy of the presentation.
Perfect.
Okay, so this answer is made. Can RTX support post-processing workflow?
Trimble RTX, as it was presented today, it's for a real-time applications. There is a post-processing service available. This is essentially only used for static data collection. So if you, for example, are setting up a base station, you may use Trimble RTX post-processing to determine a high accuracy position for that base station.
Okay. How Trimble RTX is compared to the competition services?
Yeah, Trimble RTX is very competitive with our competitive services from our colleagues and other companies. It's very similar in terms of delivery and availability. However, Trimble is currently leading with the largest coverage area for fast convergence and the accuracy to meet that convergence. So we have the best convergence availability in North America and Europe.
Okay, so is RTX supported by non-Trimble receivers?
At this time, RTX is only supported by Trimble receivers.
What is your future plans in ME, I guess, Middle East regions?
As a whole, we are globally, we are continuously improving Trimble RTX positioning. This is actually one of the key benefits of a subscription-based service. You pay for the subscription and any improvements that are made to the service are continuously included with your subscription, so you automatically receive those. I can't speak about the Middle East specifically, but we are continuously researching and improving the service.
Thank you. Is Trimble XFill a part of Trimble RTX?
Trimble XFill uses the Trimble RTX correction stream and is a part of the Trimble RTX technology. However, it is not a subscription-based service. Trimble XFill is included for free on select Trimble receivers, and it will be a backup to RTK or VRS, whereas Trimble RTX is not a backup, it is a full-fledged correction.
Okay, so no question anymore. Feel free to ask your questions here. We have plenty of time.
Let's wait a minute and see if any more questions come in. Oh, yes.
Yeah, perfect. Is Trimble RTX Centerpoint, can we use it in Indonesia?
Yes, absolutely. Trimble RTX Centerpoint is available in Indonesia via satellite delivery. That'll probably be the main interest, but also via delivery of internet.
What is the minimum and maximum duration of an RTX subscription?
We have RTX subscriptions available in 3-month duration, and maximum subscription length that we're offering is 5 years. However, you can stack on the maximum duration and get many more years if you needed.
Okay, next question. What is the Trimble XFill Extended?
Trimble XFill Extended. So XFill Premium is our service name. XFill, the way XFill Premium works is you have your regular XFill, which is included for free with, for example, the Trimble R12i. If you lose your RTK or VRS correction, you will automatically switch to Trimble XFill. However, XFill is a subset of RTX technology, so it degrades over time, and after 5 minutes, it will degrade and it'll cut off. With XFill Premium, that degradation is limited, and you have unlimited availability of XFill. Essentially, you transition from RTK to RTX. So the benefit of this is if you ever lose your connection to RTK or VRS, you are able to continuously position indefinitely with no time limit and still achieve centimeter level positioning.
Okay, next question. Why do I use RTX if I have VRS?
If you have VRS available and you have very good connectivity, cellular availability, and you are sticking to the region of where the VRS network is available, there isn't a use for RTX. However, RTX complements VRS in the case that you do have cellular problems or you are traveling outside of your VRS network availability. So that is when you'd use RTX, if you have issues with cellular connectivity or if you're traveling outside of your VRS network.
Okay, thank you, Tufik. Next question. Does RTX operate on offshore locations?
Yes, we currently have RTX available for some offshore locations within 5 kilometers off the coast, as well as we're looking to, we have availability within 5 kilometers off the coast. For more information about that, contact your Trimble reseller and we can get you connected.
Okay, next question. How to get directly into the UTM coordinate system, especially in Germany?
Sure, so if you're using any Trimble software, the positions are calculated in ITRF, this is in the global system, and the software will project to UTM. However, if you want to get into the datum that's of interest in Germany, you can use the latest version of Trimble Access, that's Trimble Access 2020 or later. And now that we support time-dependent transformations, the software will automatically transform to the datum of choice in Germany and then project to UTM. So you will match very closely in Germany to the German coordinate system.
Okay, thank you. Does coordinate system improvement apply also to XFIL?
The coordinate system improvement does not apply to XFIL, but it is not necessary for XFIL. The way XFIL had always worked is through an offset message. So XFIL, while you were doing your RTK survey, XFIL would work in the background and calculate an offset from ITRF to your RTK survey. And then once you switch to XFIL, that offset is applied. So you don't need to do a coordinate system transformation.
Okay, next question. Is it possible to use RTX on an island? Its area is about 2,500 hectares.
I would need more information about where the island is located, but it is 100% possible to use RTX there. The availability of internet is available anywhere, or corrections via internet is available anywhere, but the question would be where is the island and whether satellite availability is there. If it is an island, you may also, if you're working offshore or near the shore of the island, you may need to have an offshore subscription.
Okay, next question. How can be the precisions of the RTX solution be compared to the VRS solution? Which solution is more robust?
On a horizontal precision level, the RTX and the VRS solutions are very comparable. They are essentially the same. With VRS being a differential technology, if you are closer to one of the physical base stations that are part of the VRS network, you will achieve much better accuracy. But in general, anywhere within the network, say you're at the maximum distance from all the physical base stations, you will achieve the same horizontal accuracy as RTX. However, on a vertical accuracy level, VRS is much more accurate than RTX at the moment. Which solution is more robust? In general, they are very similar. However, VRS converges instantly, while RTX is less than a minute in fast regions or less than 15 minutes globally. Therefore, especially globally, you may notice more robustness with VRS as it will converge instantly after losing the correction. However, in fast regions, that is almost non-noticeable as it happens very quickly.
Okay. Next questions. In terms of costs, how much are we looking at with RTK XFIL subscription?
So RTK, that's referring to, if you're referring to a single base station, you'll have to contact your local reseller to get a cost for purchasing a base station, the radio, any other radio for maybe your rover and maybe any other licensing requirements. And XFIL is included for free with select Trimble receivers. That includes the R10, the R12, and the R12i. For VRS Now and RTX subscriptions, please also contact your local Trimble reseller and you can find out the cost.
Okay, next question. Will RTX replace VRS in the future?
We see RTX as a complementary technology to VRS. There are unique benefits of each. As of today, RTX is not fully capable of delivering the same levels of vertical precision as VRS. Therefore, right now, we cannot replace VRS with RTX, but they do complement each other. Whereas VRS requires internet connectivity, RTX does not.
Okay, next question. Can RTX be delivered over internet? I'm thinking of an application in an urban environment with limited access to the sky.
Yes, absolutely. The same RTX corrections that are delivered over satellite are also available to be accessed over internet. And that is a very good application and use case to be using internet delivery. If you do have any sort of obstructions that are limiting your accessibility to the satellite that's delivering the correction.
Okay, so we are at the time and I don't see any more questions.
Yep.
So
looks like it was that. That was a lot of good questions.
Yeah.
Great. Yeah, thank you everybody for the questions. I'm happy to answer them. You may also find me on LinkedIn. Feel free to connect and I'm happy to discuss with you more or get you in touch with somebody to get you a demonstration.
So there's also an option of going to the intergeo.trimble.com and signing up for a one-on-one meeting to talk to an expert also. So you can either reach out directly to Tawfiq or somebody from our technical sales teams can also support you. So go to intergeo.trimble.com. And otherwise, thank you very much, Tawfiq and Maximilian, for your help here and for presenting. And all attendees will also have a follow-up email with the recording of this presentation.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.